like to welcome you to the Beacon Board of Education. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Show call, please. Mrs. Antolik Everett?
Here.
Mrs. Gadsden?
Here.
Mrs. Galvo?
Here.
Mr. Garnett?
Here.
Mr. Munoz?
Here.
Mrs. Patchen?
Here.
Mr. White?
Here.
Mr. Zoff?
Here.
Mrs. Thompson?
Here.
That's welcome to the fire exits.
I will. The fire exits are directly in front of me and behind you. There's an emergency. Go out the door.
I'd like to ask everyone to stand for a moment of silence for Rhonda Galarza, a former food service worker and cook at South Avenue School. Thank you.
Tonight is a special night because this is the night that we show appreciation to the board. And we have some speakers this evening who are going to be speaking to the board, and we also have a proclamation. And I'd like to start with a proclamation to head off the festivities. So Kelly, our board clerk, is going to read that.
Whereas each year, School Board Recognition Week is observed by the more than 700 school boards and school districts throughout the Empire State, and whereas the men and women serving as members of school boards are dedicated to children, learning, and community, and devote many hours of service to elementary and secondary public education as they continually strive for improvement, excellence, and progress in education. And whereas the members of New York's local school boards respond to the educational needs of the communities they serve, and in doing so, these leaders help strengthen our state's educational system and improve future prospects for our children. And whereas during October 27th through 31st, 2014, special activities and programs will be held in communities across New York State in observance of School Board Recognition Week. And it is fitting to join in acknowledging the commitment and contributions of members of local school boards. Now, therefore, I, Andrew M. Cuomo, Governor of the State of New York, do hereby proclaim October 27th through 31st, 2014, as School Board Recognition Week in the Empire State.
Thank you. And in recognition of your service, there's a little pin there for you if you want to take a look at that. And while they're doing that, I believe one of our speakers is Mr. Eric Romeo. The president of our administrators union.
Good evening. It gives me great pleasure to recognize you, the Board of Education, for your countless hours that you have dedicated to quality education in our district. The school district has gone through many changes over the past few years, and with great pride and in a collaborative effort, the administrators and the Board of Education worked through the challenges of change to provide the leadership the district needed. We once again look forward in working with you in an effort to carry out the vision for our school district. Once again, congratulations for being honored on this day of recognition. Thank you.
And I believe one of our principals has brought something from the school.
Good evening, everyone. This is a little token of appreciation from Sergeant Stars, signed by a number of kids in our school. Just a thank you for all your support.
Thank you.
And thank you to the students as well. I believe Mrs. Atwell has something as the president of the teachers union.
Hi, good evening, everyone. Before we start, I'd like to just, everyone short? Yes, we are. Vicki, come on. I'd like to introduce our public relations committee. They've put together some special treats for the Board of Education tonight. And we have Leslie Tompkins from Forestville, Amy Frazetta from Glenham, Terry Lucido from Forestville, and Vicki M. Long time, I can't get it right. From Glenham as well, so. As the president of the Beacon Teachers Association, I have come to the podium many times. Each year on this night, I speak on behalf of our teachers to recognize the efforts of our Board of Education and to show our appreciation for the advocacy you demonstrate on behalf of the school district and the community at large. Many times, the work that you do is misunderstood, underappreciated, and deemed as unnecessary. However, there are many pieces to the puzzle that so often are overlooked. Work cannot be shared due to the mandates or regulations or laws, so many misperceptions. And the bottom line is I've been here for someone who's attended almost all of the board meetings. I think you may have missed two or three. Over the past 7 years, I can attest that the focus from this Board of Education and previous Board of Education has always been about our students. The BTA is always about our students. That is our philosophy, that's what we represent, so we share the same mission and vision as the board. Thank you all for the work that you do on behalf of our school district. It does not go unnoticed. So we have some treats as we always do. Hope we're good.
You didn't put any
fun on
this year,
so you
don't have to They do not have a
Congratulations and thank you again.
So I would like to top off the gratitude that I'm hearing this evening. Oh, we have students. I'm sorry.
City Council at Beacon High School would like to recognize the board.
Thank you.
Hi, sorry. My name is Addison Rakowski. I'm president of student council. It's Michael Andrews, treasurer of student council. We would like to thank you for all your service and dedication to the Beacon City School District. So, Mr. Munoz. It's going to take a while, I guess. Ms. Galbo. Mrs. Gadsden.
Thank you.
Mrs. Everett. Mr. Zopp. Mr. Zopp. Mr. Gono. Mr. White and Mrs. Thompson. What's
Are there any other speakers? Okay, thank you. So I'd like to top off the gratitude that we're feeling this evening, and the focus question that I was thinking about is, who is a board member, and what drives them to be a member of the board? Oftentimes when people sit in the audience, as you are this evening, and they look at the work of the board and they say, you know, I think that I'd like to get up there because I have this agenda, or I have, it looks pretty easy and you just have to show up. And once you get up here, I think that our new members are finding, and our veteran members find, that it's more work than you thought. And they get to look at a law book that's this thick, and we have our board policy book that's this thick. And there's a lot of reading and a lot that people learn as a board member, and I think that that's why people stay on the board, because it's a great job to have. It's the best job that you'll have without any pay. So I found a quote that I thought was really appropriate. This is a quote from Shirley Chisholm, and she says, "Service is the rent we pay for the privilege of living on this earth." So I'm going to thank all of you for paying your rent in this way, and we appreciate all that you do for our students. Thank you.
Thank you.
Motion to adjourn to executive session to review the employment history of a particular individual, and the board will return as soon as possible.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Thank you all for coming out. For those that did not stay until after executive session, we all appreciate all of you honoring us.